This is Bill Newman, WHMP.
Welcome to the show. And we welcome to the show and to the studio Rich Michelson and Michael Caine and Carrie Cuthbert. We are here with them today because we want you to know about Authors and Illustrators for Democracy. And for those of our listeners who don't know, we want you to know about the Movement Voter Project. So let me start with Michael Caine, who is a retired economic development specialist, a Movement Voter Project volunteer. Michael, I know you've been with MVP for many years, I think almost since the beginning, and I would appreciate if you would share with our audience what the Movement Voter Project is and why you are involved.
Thanks, Bill. Movement Voter Project was started by Billy Wimsatt, who lives here in Northampton, in 2015. And he wanted to figure out a way to support grassroots groups in key swing states, principally groups of color and youth and people in the LGBTQ community, and figure out a way to harness their organizing power around elections and getting good people elected and preserving the integrity of our election system. So MVP has been raising hundreds of millions of dollars, funding these groups and helping these groups be effective in building a mass movement.
As I understand it from Billy, what the theory of the Movement Voter Project is give money to groups in states and municipalities and regions where they already exist. These are the grassroots groups. These are the people who live there. This is not giving money to a political party. It's giving money to organizations on the ground who know the people, who know the local politics, who know how to organize. And if we give money to organizations that already exist and that have this kind of effectiveness and infrastructure, that's way more effective than giving money, for example, to a political party. Your thoughts about that?
Yeah, well, I think you should be a spokesperson for MVP. That was great. Yeah, it's basically trying to harness all of that energy and the work that those community groups are doing. They're working in their communities 365 days a year. They build relationships with people, they build trust, and they work on a whole range of issues. And that trust-building relationship, I think, is critical because you can't just parachute in, ask people to vote a week before the election and think they're going to get motivated and registered. It takes an awful lot of time and energy, and those grassroots groups are the best at doing it.
And the other part of this that's so exciting is that the groups continue. They're there before the election. They'll be there after the election. The organizing goes on. It's a long-term strategy. And when you look at long-term strategies, and I hate to use the analogy, but you look what the right wing and the religious right has done to usurp, to destroy the right to reproductive choice. It was a long-term strategy, and they've won on that. It's a sad, sad reflection, but I think it's something that we should note. The long game really matters. So does the short game. Let me turn, if I might, to Carrie Cuthbert, who is a Movement Voter Project volunteer and a donor with a long career in social justice work. I'd appreciate knowing from you, Carrie, why'd you become involved with MVP?
Yeah, I got involved back in 2020. You know, as you said, I've had a long career in social justice, and I was looking for some way to really have a much bigger impact than I felt like I've had in the past in what I see as this battle that's been happening in our country between democracy and human rights on one side and rising authoritarianism on the other. And I see that happening and that battle playing out through all levels of our society and government and actually globally too. And so even though I care so deeply about so many specific issues from women's rights to climate to reproductive rights and on, when I learned about movement voter strategy of moving dollars to grassroots organizations in states where races are winnable or tippable and you could get progressives in power and, as you say, have not just win elections for the short term, but you're investing in the people who have authentic relationships in the communities where these issues are most deeply affecting people. And that short-term and long-term strategy was so compelling to me, and we've seen that it works.
So, Carrie, I understand the part of your description, the intro that I gave to you, that you're a donor, which is crucial because what Movement Voter Project does is it distributes funds. And now, and Billy started this with nothing. He started this with an idea two election cycles ago, and now they're giving away and giving away tens of millions of dollars. It's really quite an extraordinary story. I understand the part you're a donor, but you're also an MVP volunteer. So what does that mean? What do you do?
So as a volunteer, I am part of the donor organizing team, both in Western Mass and nationally. And you just nailed it. I mean, what MVP does so beautifully is it organizes donors and helps donors invest their money in the way, in the most effective way possible, which is investing in grassroots organizations. So much of what MVP does is support volunteers to hold fundraising house parties, you know, originally, you know, in person and now virtually, to raise money for the grassroots groups that are going to win elections for progressives and really begin to build the power we need in terms of progressives to make the deep transformational change we need in this country on an array of issues. So it's really, you know, I spend time helping to organize house parties, thanking other donors, reaching out to people I know who I think might want to get involved and also raise money and move their money into these grassroots groups, you know, all in service to really to defending our democracy.
Yeah, and what Movement Voter Project does for all of its donors and all of its supporters is it curates the list, the groups. It says, here are the really great, effective, wonderful groups who are organizing in XYZ county or city or town.
Yeah, I mean, it's such an antidote to the overwhelm of the scale of the problems we're all trying to fix. You know, when you donate to MVP, that they have vetted the best grassroots groups all over the country. You don't have to do all that work. You don't have to worry about it. You trust them to find the best people on the ground who can turn voters out. And it's such a relief, and it's such a great way for me to just channel my outrage about what's happening in this country into something that's hopeful and into action that I know is going to change lives.
In addition to Carrie Cuthbert and Michael Caine, Movement Voter Project volunteers, we have with us Rich Michelson, which, of course, is the host of...
Oh, no. I heard Rich Michelson, so his intro music just pops up out of nowhere.
Well done, Monty. Rich Michelson, of course, is the host of NPR, Northampton Poetry Radio, here on the show, and he is the owner of our Michelson Gallery, and he is an author and just a person who, not just, but he is a person who contributes to this community in a thousand different ways. He is hosting Authors and Illustrators for Democracy at the R. Michelson Gallery this coming Monday, May 16th at 7 o'clock. Rich, Carrie just mentioned, and it just brings chills to my spine, the authoritarianism that is taking over the country. Not only what we've seen from Donald Trump and what we might see from the Republicans, Donald Trump, should Trump and or a Trump-like person become president again, but also from the Supreme Court, which has now decided to destroy vital constitutional rights and really invest in misogyny as a policy of the country and the court. The title.
Tell us what you think, Bill. Don't tiptoe around these issues.
Carrie just mentioned the authoritarianism, and the event at your gallery. This coming Monday, Authors and Illustrators for Democracy. The title is I think, both illustrative and moving and evocative. Tell us about this event on this coming Monday, please.
Okay, well, first, Bill, I need to let you know that it is not an event happening at the gallery.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It is a virtual event that will be nationwide. So while we encourage people to come visit the gallery during the day, Monday night we will not be there. My door will be closed because I will be on a Zoom. But I think this is, this is an important event. When Michael came to me and told me about the Movement Voter Project, asked if I'd be willing to help, I was very happy to jump in. A lot of people know my book. What's the title? As Good as Anybody, Martin Luther King and Abraham Joshua Heschel's. It's been a while. Amazing March Towards Freedom. I spent a lot of time steeped in the research of that book. And and the time frame of that time when Martin Luther King and Abraham Joshua Heschel and so many other faith leaders and lay leaders were trying to change the country, were trying to vote. It was that simple. They were trying to vote. When King first started the march from Montgomery to Selma, literally 2% of black people were on the voter rolls. They could not get on the voter rolls. And I see the way today we are going backwards. We are trying to keep people from voting. King and Heschel, of course, marched for it. They went. They put their lives on the line. At the time, the U.S. Supreme Court stepped in to change some of the rules. We can't count on the Supreme Court anymore, which means that we have to do it. Each of us has to do our part. We have to do it person by person. So Michael explained to me what he's trying to do and what this group is trying to do, and he asked if I would be willing to speak to that issue. And I said, well, let's get some friends involved. So I called my friend Mark Brown, who many people know as the creator of Author, the longest-running PBS television show in history, and spent the last 35 years doing these issues. Why Mark Brown? Author might seem like is a character that is reaching kids, that is reaching teens, that is reaching young adults, and also is, Mark has had his books banned, believe it or not, and the shows have been banned. He understands how important it is, and he is as well raising his voice to this. I should say that if people want to go online and check out at the gallery site, Mark Brown, and see the illustrations that he has done during the week after our talk at the Movement Voter Project, we will be donating 10% of any sales to the Voter Movement Project. And if you buy something, you will also get a 10% discount yourself. Feel free to donate that full 20%, but that is up to you. We're asking not more than you're willing to give. And we'll also be talking with Lori Kresney Brown, who wrote the book called Dinosaurs for Democracy. Just as we have to, each of us, do our part and play the long-term game, Lori is trying to get children involved. And by children, I mean parents, too. It's a book for everyone to read that describes how important democracy is, how important the vote is. Everyone has to vote. We are seeing our society falling apart because people are not going out to vote, and the majority of of our voices is not being heard. So I'm jumping in to do this, and will be on Zoom Monday night. Michael, can you tell me how people listen in?
Probably because it's going to be virtual, probably the best way to do if people are interested in attending and registering is to email me mcaneconsulting@gmail.com, and I will make sure that you can register for this event. But I also want to make a point here. PEN, the International Writers Group, released a press release in April of this year. And here's just a couple of quick data points. Between July 1st of last year and March 31st of this year, 1,586 books were banned in 86 school districts, affecting 2,899 schools and over 2 million students. The bans have targeted 874 different authors and illustrators, and 42 of those are children's books. So the forces behind that effort to ban and impose restrictions are the same forces that Carrie talked about that MVP is trying to fight.
So, Michael Caine, tell us one more time, how do people sign up, register to no charge to register to be part of Authors and Illustrators for Democracy next Monday, May 16th at 7 o'clock? How do we do that?
email me at mcaneconsulting@gmail.com, and I will make sure that you get the registration link.
And you can also email the gallery if you'd like. I'll make sure I put up a link today. So if you email me, rm@rmichelson, M-I-C-H-E-L-S-O-N.com, but we'll also have a link on the gallery website so you can join in.
So I would like to thank Rich Michelson and Michael Caine and Carrie Cuthbert for being with us today, for telling us about the Movement Voter Project. And by way of disclosure, I am a supporter of the Movement Project and have been since the beginning. Thank you also very much for your work. It's really, really, really important, especially today.
Thank you.
Thank you.
This is Bill Newman, WHMP.